That moment when you got a guardian skin, but had no dragon. Hello guys, welcome back to our channel. It's finally the end of season 10. The meta has changed, meaning we have to revisit our RTA budget monster pool that we can use to get G1 or G2 that we did for season 9. Okay, let's see what are the changes. Let's go. So here we are. What you guys see at the left is my new RTA pool for this season. Now some units are out from last season like Vela Jewel because of Deadness, the most OP monster in this meta right now, too pay to win. But some units are in, like the Fire Inugami and the Lauren, yeah? There are more free-to-play viable units this season actually, like Simatei, Clara, but I haven't built them and have a better substitute like the Lagmaron there for my Simatei substitute. And also I have Triton, so I have no reason to build Clara. Now thanks to Deadness and all, this meta is actually Swift, guys. The Swift meta. Can you believe it? It's not violent meta! What the heck? So, I too built my monsters on Swift to counter this Gianna, this Swift Deadness, this Swift Ganymede, Swift Hathor. So cancer! So yeah, I'm gonna show you guys what are my favorite Swift comp right now, the one I use often, and how I utilize them. Let's roll the clips! Now, the reason Lauren is so good in this meta is because she acts as a disruptor. She's gonna ruin the combo, guys. I mean, what's this? This guy relies on his Triana to go first, right? For his Ganymede to continue into stripping and... not stripping, but Seal of Magic. But since we have the Lauren, it's not gonna happen. We push back the attack bar of the Triana. Now his Ganymede is faster than the Triana. So he's gonna waste a turn instead. And this Triana is gonna use Wind of Change into nothing! I mean, it's not Inferno is gonna kill the Vanessa, but... this is where Lauren is going to prove herself that he's more than just a disruptor. With Lauren and Ferd in the team, most likely the opponent is never gonna take a turn. Turn cycling, guys. The meta that we saw from last season is actually still in effect for this season. Turn cycling. See? I mean, so we have 3 free-to-play units on our board against 4 pay-to-win units on the board. But with the right combo, they're never gonna take a turn. Instead, we're gonna roll all over the board. See? Had to kill the Triana here because I'm afraid she has the Wind of Change already. But there we go, the bird. And the panda is never gonna take a turn. Not as long as Lauren then Kurt is on the field. Now another popular Swift combo in this meta is one shot. I mean look, Deadness one shot, free win. Wolfer Amelia one shot, Molong one shot, free win. So guess what? I want my own budget one shot comp too. So the way I do it is to use the Fire Inugami and the Lagmaron, depending on the opponent's element. Now you guys see a lot of videos about my Lagma already, right? So instead we're gonna see Dogo clips. So the clip is against the same guy. Now he knows that the reason he lost is because Lauren is so OP. Therefore I know in my mind he's gonna ban the Lauren. 200 IQ, guys. So instead, I let through his Yeonhong and I ban his Triana. Now since I have Raok in my comp and Garou, I have enough damage to one-shot the Yeonhong. The attack buff from front is also necessary. Look, Raok is gonna damage the Yeonhong, give attack bar to the Garou. But he doesn't even need the Garou to finish off the Yeonhong. Cause Raok is gonna proc! And now from here on it's GG. What can he do? I have immunity and his Ganymede's not gonna do shit. That's why front is so good, guys. Even after the nerf, I still first pick front most of the time. Now Sori can kill my thing, he can find proc, but Perna is actually very weak against Garou. I mean, Rao. Because he dies, he comes back, he dies again! Bye bye. Now, the reason I use Garou for my Rao comp is because of this clip, guys. Look, yeah. So yeah, this guy right here. So the way he makes his Rao comp work is by using the stat, whereas I try to use either Ciara or maybe Vanessa. But this is what's so cool about being budget. You may only have like 1 or 2 premium units and yet you get to make them work by the available free to play units. I mean look, I banished the stat and now his team are all free to play, whereas mine, not so much. But look, he's still gonna win. My only critic is the Susanoo here. I don't understand why he picks the Susanoo, I mean, he does basically nothing. But look, the Garou synergy and the first synergy with the Rao is gonna kill. And then, Rao is also very good against Vanessa because with the revive, Rao will be like, hey, go back to where you came from. Yeah, he just touched my Ciara, and that gives him another chance to team up with the synergy from Garou and Rurt, dishing way too much damage for my unit to handle. So this is where I get my idea of using Garou for the round home. Now just one final clip to show you guys how I deal with Daphnis. Now usually the way I deal with Daphnis speed comp like this is to pick Lagmaron and just one shot someone else while I ban the Daphnis. But in this case I'm gonna let the Daphnis through. Now most Daphnis are run on Swift in this season because they just need to get first turn and nuke, so they have very high attack but they have very low HP. So therefore with the Rauk here, you can just touch with unit like Furt and then Rauk is enough to kill a squishy Daphnis. That is the weakness of Daphnis. And that is why I think this meta is so on Swift. Now, you guys tell me your experience in this season, okay? We get to exchange experience, tell me in the comment section, and that is what I like about this, okay? For now, we are going to show the changes that I did to my rune for this season. Let's go! Okay, so there are not many changes I did to my runes. Most of my runes are still on the same monster. You can find from the previous videos about the season 9, okay? The only one I'm gonna show is the one I changed into Swift, and the one I freshly built, like this route here. So I think Rauk needs a little HP, not that much attack, just enough speed for unit like Furt or Lauren to disrupt the opponent, give yourself attack bar for the Rauk to take a turn or cut in between. And he's on Revenge Violet. Next is the Furt. Yeah, I changed my Furt from Fire into Swift because I need him to buff up my team to get a turn, and this requires Swift sadly. So there we go, now he's more squeezy but more nukies. Okay, the biggest change of all is my front. Now this is on my best Swift set because he needs to go first, give attack up. And just in case if we're against people like Gianna or Daphnis, I'm not gonna buff up attack. Instead, I'm gonna reduce their attack bar. Now, see? There's a merit into front's nerf. Now, this is also a disruptor, like Lauren. Oh, and speaking of Lauren, this is how I built my Lauren on Swift. Yeah, because I need her to be the second fastest in the team so that I can disrupt the opponent's turn for my units. My units like Rauk, Furt, or Garou, they all need the disruption that comes from Lauren passive. So of course I'm gonna give her Swift. Make her tanky. Lauren is not a nuke unit, okay guys. No need to give her attacks, not gonna do shit. So instead just make him tanky, make her more annoying to be on the field. Okay, so that's all there is to it. So guys, please help me pick which dragon I should choose for this season. Should I be optimist and believe that my first LD is gonna be a light or dark dragon? Hey, you know what? I'm gonna let you guys decide for me, okay? So I'm gonna pick the dragon that's gonna appear most in the comment section. So you guys decide for me, please. So yeah, that's it. I hope you guys were able to learn a lot from this season. And maybe I'll do some more sort of showcase for the special league, maybe on stream. So I'll see you guys later, okay? Bye! Hey guys, thanks for watching the video. If you guys like this video, make sure to hit the thumbs up and hit the bell button. Also, don't forget to follow me on Twitch and Discord, which you can find the link down below.